So this session is regarding artificial intelligence code 417 CBSE. So the basic focus of the session will be to enable you when you go away after this session, to enable you to, when you are watching some video in artificial intelligence, you should be able to get it easily. When you are going through the book or preparing for the classroom session, so you should be able to do that easily. That is the prime focus of this entire session. So when we talk about artificial intelligence and we try to understand, we try to segregate it away from basic programming. We all have been programmers. I suppose all IT teachers are there mostly. And in our life, we have written certain very big, small, complex programs. Some of us might have developed software also. So we have all been programmer at some stage in our lives. And we have written programs. So it is really amazing to wonder as a programmer how artificial intelligence is different from it. That also involves computer programming. We talk about Python and other programming languages in connection with artificial intelligence also. Then how these terms, artificial intelligence, machine learning, deep learning, how are they distinct from basic computer programming? So first of all, let's clear the fog on this, and that's the very basic of entire thing that you are going to learn, because once this is clear, that is the 80% concept clearing in artificial intelligence. The rest is what you just go through the concepts and understand them like you do in any other subject. So when we are talking about a computer program, if I'm writing a program, that program is actually the response to creating a solution for a problem. So when I'm writing a program, I'm actually trying to answer a problem at hand. For example, if I want to find out how many visitors have come to my website and actually bought the product and how many did not, I can write a program about that. There is a program that can tell me about that. Well, how artificial intelligence is different from it? In our computer program, two things are important. One is the input that has to be processed, and the instructions which are built into the program, which are logically arranged in the program, which process that input and they give out the answer. They give some answer which may be desirable, maybe not. So that is the basic premise on which every computer program and entire software is built. Some input, instructions are there. According to the instructions, input it process and answer is given. In artificial intelligence, of course, program is there. But here program behaves in a very different manner. Here program does not take inputs and does not give answers like that. Here actually what happens, the computer algorithm or the program takes a lot of data. For example, the image of an animal, or for example, data of past 1 year of 10,000 employees. So that computer program takes that data, and after analyzing that data, it finds some sort of relation among the data points. For example, looking at the data, a computer program can conclude that these figures are very close to each other, they can be grouped together. Or these figures are very different from others, they can be separated in a separate group. So those data values are analyzed, some sort of relationship, some sort of association is analyzed by the computer, and whatever relationship and connection among the data values is understood by the program, on that basis, the program builds a model. The program creates certain rules, and on those rules, it builds a model, and that model is kept ready. Now, whenever some new data comes in, that data is compared, that data is applied on that model. And that model already has certain rules, which it has created by analyzing some previous historic data. So that is, those rules are applied on the new data and the answers are given. The predictions are done. The comparisons are done. The classifications are done. So in this way, artificial intelligence approach is different. That is also programming, but approach is different. In computer programming, input is given of data, and on the instructions, data is processed. In artificial intelligence, the core thing is data itself. algorithm looks at the data, learns from the data, after learning creates a model, and that model is used to do predictions and other useful things with whatever data comes in future. There are two phases. First phase is training phase. In artificial intelligence, the algorithm, the program, first of all learns from the data which is there. It is taught with the data. That is actually called machine learning. We teach the computer by exposing it to a lot of data, variety of data about certain thing. After learning, after training, that model which is built is capable to process same kind of data and do predictions on its own. So that's more intelligent. That's more intelligent approach towards programming. Now, why is the use of this? Why were not programs were not good enough? They have been and they are still working there. Then why this kind of approach? The simple answer is, today in online environment, as we talk here, there are so much data around there that a traditional program cannot process it. We cannot build into one program all the possible permutations, all the possible conditions. We cannot check with F, if, else, or the loops, while, for, do, while. It is not possible for a program to check all the possible permutations, combinations of all kind of data that is coming in every moment. It's a deluge of big data and variety of data. But an artificial intelligence model, which has already been taught with the data, is capable to process it. That is why this approach. So this is regarding one a very quick introduction to artificial intelligence. Why do we have artificial intelligence and how it is different from basic computer programming? That is why this definition of artificial intelligence has come out. The art and science of creating machines. When we say machines, actually they are computer programs. Actually those are computers, electronic devices. So art and science of creating machines which exhibit human-like intelligence, which are capable of making decisions, which are capable of learning from the data and deciding the future strategy, do predictions, understand the data. So that is what artificial intelligence, and that is why it is different from traditional computer programming. So as I was discussing with you, the difference between traditional programming approach and artificial intelligence. In artificial intelligence, the program learns from that exposure of data, creates a model, and that model is used to process the new data and generate the answers out of it. Now, when we talk about artificial intelligence on the basis of intelligence level and functionality, there are various types of artificial intelligence. Let's have a quick view. One is the narrow intelligence, also known as weak intelligence. The other is generalized or strong intelligence. Weak intelligence is focused on limited functionality, like a device is doing a particular task only. For example, your electronic watch is checking on your fitness data and advising you that how much exercise you should do. Now it is performing a particular task. So that's a limited functionality. And such kind of intelligence needs some input, needs a lot of inputs and guidance also. So that's not a true intelligence actually. A strong or generalized intelligence is actually those machines which are under development, which are able to think like humans, which are able to exhibit human-like intelligence, able to make decisions, taking the stimulus and sensing the stimulus and the input and making decisions, deciding the course of action in future. That is generalized intelligence, and that's on the basis of intelligence level. If you talk about functionality, there are basically four types. Reactive machines, which are very good at playing games. These are very useful. They show basic type of intelligence, and they have a very basic set of rules built into them. Those rules are frozen or embedded into them, and according to those rules, they function. For example, an expert system which can diagnose a disease or which can suggest some medication depending on the symptoms given to it. So this kind of intelligence is called reactive machines intelligence. Then limited memory intelligence are those machines which cannot learn. Their logic, every time they are switched on, their logic is loaded fresh in the memory, and they are basically able to process the visual data. For example, autonomous vehicles, self-driven cars, that's an example of limited memory. So if an AI based car is moving around in traffic, once that it records, it responds to the stimulus gathered from around everywhere, and it makes its way through the pathway on the road through a crowd. But when it goes back into the garage, when it is shut down, it does not remember anything. It does not learn from the data. Reactive machines also do not learn from the data. Then we have theory of mind. These machines are more intelligent than the other two, and they are capable to respond in a very social way. They try to understand the emotions of the user. They are able to understand and interpret the gestures, the expressions on the face, and they can respond accordingly in their human-like voice. Like you might have heard about Sophia the robot. That's an example of theory of mind kind of machine. Then there is fourth category, which is still under development, which is still a dream, which show true intelligence like human beings, and they are still far in future. And we are also conceiving an artificial super intelligence, which is the highest form of AI, maybe intelligence more fast, which can think faster than humans and more intelligent than humans. And these are self-evolving machines which will be able to program themselves. Those who have seen movies like Terminator can visualize that. So these are the five basic categories on the basis of functionality. Artificial intelligence is actually a broad term under which all the technologies which are pertaining to AI, which are pertaining to developing intelligent machines, they all fall under the premise of artificial intelligence. Machine learning is one big area where most of the things are happening today. Machine learning is what I was talking about, that a machine is exposed with a lot of data and it is made to learn from it, and after learning it is able to perform certain useful things. Then there is the term deep learning. Deep learning is a sophisticated form of machine learning itself. It is more advanced form of machine learning, and you can say that it is a kind of machine learning more intelligent than traditional machine learning. In this, what happens, the basic purpose is same, doing predictions or processing the data and coming out with useful patterns and predicting the future kind of things, or classifying the things, or learning certain useful things. But the approach is based on something called neural network, artificial neural network. So when we will understand that, we will understand deep learning, the point when I'll come to that, discussing that. So that is the basic introduction to artificial intelligence. Today what happens is businesses actually want to know the future. If I have made a product, if a new school is opened, if a teacher is teaching in the classroom, whatever it is, we are concerned with the future, how the students will perform, whether the customer will buy the product or not. If the customer will buy the product, would he try to return the product and ask for the refund or not? Or what should be my salary after 5 years? So these kind of questions we keep asking with ourselves. We keep analyzing depending on the data available, and we keep doing it in our daily life. What actually we are doing is something called data science. Now this is something new which has moved into this discussion. I was talking about artificial intelligence, machine learning, deep learning, and suddenly this data science. Data science, I am telling you, is actually the soul of artificial intelligence. Whatever we do with the data to find out something useful out of it, that process is called data science. Data science is the approach to make sense of the data which I have. So if I have the data of 100 students' exams, past exams, I am trying to figure out which students will pass, which students will have the distinction, which students need more efforts in preparation. What actually I'm doing is I'm practicing data science. And when we talk about data science, another term moves in, that is called statistics. So data science is actually based on the algorithms which are already there in the statistics. Now, how does it connect with artificial intelligence? Data science is practiced earlier, in earlier days, it was practiced manually by the help of mathematics. Now, today we have sophisticated programs. We have powerful computers which can process huge bulk of data and any kind of data quickly and fastly. There are intelligent algorithms. So if we can convert those data science algorithms into artificial intelligence programs, and then we expose those programs with the data, our intelligent machines will come into being. So this is where data science moves into the picture. Data science, artificial intelligence is actually the combination of data science practices and machine learning practices brought together. So in data science, what happens? We prepare the data for the computer program, artificial intelligence algorithm. And then artificial intelligence algorithm goes through that data to teach itself about that data so that it can do some useful tasks. So that's the connection between data science and artificial intelligence. All the practices, all the logic of AI, all the figuring out what is the data about, what to do with the data, all that figuring out, all that approach comes from data science. And then that approach is translated into program in the area of machine learning. And then that program is used for training and using it.